Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Windsor Brokers Live Daily Market Outlook. Today is Wednesday, 28th of November 2012. The world focus quickly turns from one to the other and changes the sentiment in the markets as initial positive tone and optimism built up on Greek expectations and final decision made yesterday about approving a further tranche of aid for Greece. Has been replaced from with the other important and I would say one of the key problems of US and of course the world economy is a so-called fiscal cliff. The push of US dollar against the majors higher has seen immediate reaction of euro falling after failure to clear 130.00, dipping down close to 129 support. Similar to pardon cable that lost traction at 60.50 and now threatening a possible double top formation. Dollar eases against Japanese yen while again gaining ground after against the Swiss franc after finding support at 92.53 yesterday's low. Commodities are again lower, crude oil attacking $87 per barrel level following upside rejection at 88.50 and 88.00, while gold is now attacking our initial support at 17.38. We're going to take a look more on technical and see more details about the outlook for today. As said, US Congress pushed towards a compromise on yesterday's meeting on the so-called fiscal cliff of tax increases and spending cuts due to take effect from early next year, but agreement still appeared elusive despite growing pressure from American business interest for action. Comments by U.S. Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid yesterday about the lack of progress by Democratic and Republican lawmakers also fanned the concerns. Investors are back into dollar and the euro against Japanese yen, as yen lost about 4% against the dollar over the past 2 weeks, as investors started to price in a possible shift in the monetary policy after Japan's elections that are due on 16th of December, with Shinzo Abe likely to emerge as the country's next leader, has called for more aggressive easing. Also, disappointment about lack of details in Greece's deal added the pressure on the single currency, while international lenders agreed, as we said yesterday, on a plan to cut Greek debt, which will allow the country to secure more financial aid and avoid the chaotic default. The market skepticism grew over the lack of details on how Athens will implement reforms required to meet its new targets, as previous experience with Athens, especially in this experience of European officials and IMF, is not that bright. From one side, the Athens is a bit, I would say, slow in implementing things. From the other side, it's growing resistance towards the current a plan that has been accepted by government, by the Greek people that are strongly against this, and a big majority in Greece is still against even Greece being in the European Union. Basically, these are the four highlights for today, and most likely will be the main drivers of today's markets, along with the technical, the economic indicators, pardon, that are due to be released today. From the Eurozone, M3 money supply and the private loans, they are coming first at 9 o'clock. October releases for money supply see a slight increase to 2.8% compared to September's 2.7%, while private loans in October are expected to stay unchanged at minus 0.8%. And basically that will be all from Europe, except the preliminary CPI from Germany that is due to be released during the day. I think it's around 1300 GMT, but I don't, I cannot confirm the exact time. Anyway, we will update our calendar accordingly. And then from US, we have new home sales due at 1500 GMT October. Releases, slight decrease in the new units to 387,000 compared to 389,000 release of the previous month. And then weekly crude in the crude oil inventories from US 1530 GMT, 1.3 million barrels build is seen of the week of the crude stocks during the past week compared to draw of 1.5 million in the previous week. A couple of speakers, Swiss National Bank Chairman Jordan is due at 17:15. At the same time, a member of Federal Reserve's FOMC, Tarullo, is also due to speak. And basically, these are the indicators for today. The calendar is not very big, but we have some important things that might be affecting the markets. Back to the technicals that I know you are most of you are expecting to see. We're going to take a look now. I do apologize. As I mentioned in morning's update, Euro is under pressure as 130 proves to be quite a tough barrier, especially in light of formation and basically completion of Evening Star looking like pattern at this point. That triggered the fresh easing from 130.07 yesterday's peak as pair failed to clear this important psychological barrier, and the fresh easing dipped as low as 129.11. This was the low of this morning, just ahead of important support at 129. It's around figure support and 38.2% Fibonacci retracement of the up leg from 127.35 to 130.07. Basically, the violation of this level could be a trigger for a stronger corrective action of the recovery rally from a 126.60 low of 13th of November that peaked at 130.07. And the break below 130, pardon, 129, that actually acts as a double Fibonacci support, as we have 50% of the larger upleg from 126.60 and 38.2% of upleg from 127.35, so offering quite strong support. A brief bounce is seen in the early hours of Europe. Still. Do not show much. We need to see it again, basically, of 129.50 zone. These are the highs of the overnight session and yesterday's lows, 129.42, 129.44. So basically, if we see the break above 129.50, then this could ease immediate bear pressure and probably to refocus the upper boundaries, 130, 130.07, and then 130.20. Level reinforced by 76 previous double top reinforced by 76.4% Fibonacci retracement. I think you can see it on the 4 hour chart. We have 130, 20, 25th and 31st of October tops and 76.4% retracement at 130, 25. As said, failure to bounce higher and again minimum 129.50 will still keep the downside vulnerable as hourly studies are in the negative territory, although started 2 points higher as the price regains initial 10 days exponential moving average. But 4 hour ones are still in descending mode and still see the downside pressure. As at 21.29 is seen as a trigger for deeper reversal. Otherwise, any reversal above this level could be a signal of formation of a higher low and a possible fresh attack higher with the signal, the initial signal seen on regain of 129.50. The British pound, approximately similar situation, double failure at 129, pardon, 160.50. Yesterday's brief crack of the level 160.55 did not result in any significant break higher with subsequent easing and the loss of initial 160.00 support, dipping as low as 159.92. With the bears as shown on the hourly ADX now in control, hourly 4 hour indicators are trend indicators are showing no trend at this point. So basically we are in the sideways mode S160 is still, I would say, intact, basically brief break lower, did not show the clear break so far. A more significant easing is required below 160 towards 150, pardon, 159 of the latest upleg. I do apologize. 159.75, where it's 61.8% retracement of the upleg from 159.26 to 160.55, and the previous high at 159.77. So basically, we have 159.75 as a break point that will signal formation of double top, first of all, and as it is a bearish pattern, could be a signal for a deeper reversal of the rally from 158.26, and probably to look for a downside, for test of downside levels as follows, 159.68. So this is basically reinforcing our initial 159.75. It's 38.2% of the larger up move from 158.26. Also the 55 days exponential moving average. As said, the break below 159.75, 70 could be seen as a trigger for a stronger corrective action, formation of and confirmation of a double top for 159.13, 61.8% retracement, and then 159 is around the figure support that will confirm the bulls are placed aside and the bears are taking control. As said, on the hourly, the bears are already in play according to the ADX, while 4 hour is still lacking a further weakness in order to confirm that a bearish tone is dominating and keeping the upside the levels intact. Only penetration above 160.50 would signal possible extension of upleg from 158.26, and the open next upside target that is approximately 160.100, 160.92 is the 76.4% retracement of the downleg from 161.74 to 158.26, and 161.00 is around figure barrier expected, the break of which expected to re-enter, reintroduce 161.74 and 161.78, 17th of October and the 1st of November double top. The broader weakness of dollar-yen continues as the pair failed on approach at 83.0082, 83 peak seen so far, and the extension below 82 as initial support, 81.84 yesterday's low, and the fresh one posted this morning at 81.71 keep the downside in focus. 4 hour ADX shows the bears now are coming in control of the latest move as 55 days moving average so far kept the dips at 81.71, but tone on the hourly chart studies that are well in the negative territory is showing that the downside is still favored in the near-term action with the 4 hour indicators building up negative momentum, and the MACD is now attempting below the midline. That could be a good signal for further extension lower, where we have 81.58 previous high of 19th of November and 38.2% retracement at 81.39 seen as the next targets, while the break below 81.00 is close to 50% retracement, and the mid-November, 16th of November, basically the consolidative range floor seen as a trigger for a deeper reversal, and keeping the upside levels intact for now. Daily structure is showing indicators quite extended as RSI is now emerging from the overbought territory, while MACD is quite extended. The strong momentum is still present, but reversal of stochastic sees potential for some more significant corrective action of the rally from 77.12 that peaked so far at 82.83, with these Fibonacci levels on the larger picture seeing 81.48 as 23.6% retracement, and more significant, I would say, is 38.2% retracement, 86 at 80.65, also previous high of 2nd of November 2012. And the dollar Swiss regained some ground on the fresh strength of the US dollar following yesterday's dip to 92.53, loss of 93.00, as we mentioned yesterday, is now keeping the focus at the downside. And basically, this current move could be described as corrective, as 93.00 is previous strong support, now acting as resistance, is still lacking the clear break. The price is briefly above 93.23, I think, yes, 93.23 seen so far, where the daily Ichimoku cloud base limited the gains so far. However, the improvement of hourly indicators is still lacking a stronger momentum for some more significant action and test of next important barriers at 93.30. These are the previous lows, as well as 38.2% retracement, and then 93.55, a high of intraday high, pardon, of 23rd of November, and 50% retracement. As said, this move could be seen as could be described as corrective, as long as 94.00 previous stronger support, as well as 200 days moving average currently at 94.11, stays intact. Only break penetration through 94 and clear break above this level could signal some fresh strength and avert immediate risk of retesting 92.13, our key near-term support low of 17th of October, break of which would signal the resumption of the broader downtrend from 99.70 high of 24, yearly high of 24th of July 2012, and open levels down towards 91 as the next target on the downside. As said, we need to see the penetration through 93.20 initial barrier and 93.30 in order to signal some stronger corrective action. But as long as 94 stays intact, this is seen as corrective and preceding a fresh weakness of the dollar Swiss as a part of the broader weakness from 99.70. And crude oil again came under pressure on the stronger dollar following yesterday's, pardon, last Friday's rejection at 88.50. Since then, the price action is in descending mode, with the lowest seen at last yesterday afternoon at 86.81. That is going to be likely revisited again, 86.91 seen so far, following a brief, sharp fall in the brief. Quick recovery up to levels close to 88. Failure to regain 88 as a round figure resistance has triggered further weakness, and the negative tone seen on the hourly chart keeps the downside in focus. 4 hour indicators are now breaking below their center lines, with the price action holding below 55 and the 20 days moving average. The 20 days one is already descending, while 55 days, pardon, one is now in the sideways mode. The bearish crossover is to confirm the negative stance and the expose immediate support 86.55. It's the tentative bull trend line drawn of 84.05, low of 7th of November through low of 85.09 of 15th of November, a break of which to turn more focus towards the downside levels and the re-expose 85.00 ahead of 84 as our key support. Larger picture tone is still, I would say, negative, as lack of stronger momentum to sustain a recovery of 84.05 bottom, and the double failure on approach to 90.00 still sees the downside vulnerable. And basically, this congestion, despite the series of higher highs and higher lows of 84.05, lacking strength to clear our trigger barrier at 90.00 and 94.32, 38.2% retracement, in order to signal some stronger corrective action of 172 to 84.05 barrier, with the 55 descending 55 days moving average currently at 89.67, so far maintaining the negative tone break of these levels, along with the previous highs, and the clearance of 90.90.42 is expected to bring some more positive tone. Otherwise, near-term downside remains vulnerable, and sees good potential for a retest of 85.00 and eventually 84 as a key near-term support. And gold moved from the from neutral to negative mode following a lack of strength to sustain last Friday's strong rally from 17.31 that peaked at 17.52. And despite breaking our initial targets at 17.46 and 17.49, lacking momentum for fresh extension towards our initial targets at 17.63 and 17.71, a loss of initial support at 17.45 has triggered further weakness down to 17.37. Basically, our initial support at 17.38 has been dented. The next one, 17.35, with the trend line support at 17.33, offering quite good support. And the violation of these levels, with the first one already being cracked, could be a signal for some stronger corrective action. Any reversal at or above these levels, especially the trend line, could still keep the possibilities of fresh strength in play, as 4-hour indicators are still in the positive territory, with the stochastic already showing signals of reversal. Momentum is starting to point higher, as well as RSI, while MACD is holding above the midline. That altogether keeps some positive tone still in play. The price is holding above 55 days exponential moving average, currently at 17.35, while 20 days one at 17, approximately 17.41 is for now capping. A break here is to bring the fresh strength in play. Near term, hourly structure is negative at this point, but showing some signals of reversal. Unless we see the break above 17.41 and regain of 17.45, that will re-enter and refocus upper barriers. Possibility of further easing is not ruled out at this point. However, the larger picture tone is still quite positive, as shown on the daily chart, as most of indicators are still pointing higher and keeping in the positive territory, with important 55 days moving average break, of which is to the upside, of course, to a signal false break of the current reversal and reintroduce levels on the upside, 17.46, 48, and then 17.52, 17.63, our initial upside targets. That was all from my side for today. Please, you can submit your questions if you have any question regarding today's session. Okay, it seems that we have no questions for today. In this case, we will conclude our today's session. Thank you for attending and being with us, and expect to see you again tomorrow morning at our regular time at 8 o'clock GMT. Until then, of course, wish you a very nice day, and of course, the most important, good and profitable trading. Good luck.